Welcome back everyone. I hope you all had a lovely Easter, and I'm back with another 12 by 12 layout for you for Aunty Vera Scrap and Craft using the gorgeous collection from BoBunny, and the collection is called Garden Grove, and the lovely paper that you see in the background there that I will be using is called Lovely. So that was the picture of my daughter I'll be scrapping, and this gorgeous frame from Scrap Mat is the inspiration for this layout. I have had this frame in my stash for quite a while, and when I saw the photo and I saw the collection, I immediately thought now is the time to get that out of the stash and onto the layout. So what you would have seen me do was I gave the chipboard a quick coat of gesso just to protect it, and now I'm just adding some pearl paints that I had in my stash. It gave it a nice pearly metallic look, if that makes any sense. From my stash, I found this gorgeous, perfect cardstock that went really well with the lovely paper. And all I did was I trimmed all four sides and then I matted it onto the cardstock. Once everything was matted, I went looking for some embellishments. And I don't have the Garden Grove ephemera pack, but the Noteworthy ephemera pack goes really well with the Garden Grove collection. So I ended up picking these three, items that were in the ephemera pack. I distressed them with my little distressing tool, but you can use your scissors if you don't have a distressing tool, so don't stress. And then I used my picked raspberry distress oxides to ink all sides of my, of my cards. One's this little notebook, one looks like an envelope, and the other one's a postcard. So I inked all of them just to give it some cohesion. And I believe that by inking my things, I give it some uniformity. My original idea was that I was going to do some embroidery when it came to framing this layout. But as I was looking for the embroidery thread, I saw this gorgeous ribbon and things changed. I landed up adhering it down using some double-sided tape that I had in my stash. And I love how well this gorgeous ribbon framed my layout and just gave it that added feminine touch. This is the Garden Grove sticker sheet. And because I'm not a big fan of stickers, only because I can never make a quick decision. So I tend to stick my stickers onto some scrap cardstock, and then I do some fussy cutting, and that way I can move them around until I make my final decision. I just want to add that everything that I'm using here from the Garden Grove collection, as well as the Noteworthy ephemera pack, are all on sale at Aunty Vera Scrap and Craft for the month of April. So please go to her website and check it out. You will be amazed at her competitive prices. I will leave a link in the description below so that you can click on the button and enjoy some isolation shopping. Hey, a bit of therapy for the old soul. It's at this stage that I start considering what I'm going to call this layout. I ended up choosing the title Love Your Eyes, mainly because every time I look at this photo, all I can see is her stunning eyes. So I did end up using three different stickers to make my title. The title wasn't looking the way that I had planned it in my head. So what I did was I got out my gesso and I primed all the thickers. And once the gesso was dried, I gave it a coating of paint using the Starlight's Pearl. It gives it this nice metallic pearl shine to it, and it matches in with the frame that I had painted earlier. And this is what the layout looks like so far. So from the ephemera pack, I also took out that lovely tag and I did some journaling. And now I'm just adding some of the candy dots from BoBunny. Just on the end of that little tag there, I love how this looks. How is everyone coping with our current situation? I actually thought that I would be doing a lot more scrapping with all this extra time at home, but I've actually found that I'm doing more things with the children. I've also been doing a lot more gardening, and for the very first time in a very long time, I'm bike riding. The other day, the kids and I decided to take a ride around the block, and I thought, yes, I can do that. Ha! I am so unfit. I can walk around the block, but get me on the bike and I only made it to the end of the street and back home. So please let me know in the comments how you're coping with this situation and if you've found some added benefits to the lockdown. I know that I'm loving having everyone home. I love being surrounded with my kids. So I am not complaining. I might actually complain at the end of it when they all go back and I'm back to being lonely little old me at home again. Okay, no more prattling on. The layout. What am I doing? Oh, yes. I'm just adding all my different ephemeras now. So here is this gorgeous butterfly, and that is from the BoBunny's Brads. Now, I love the BoBunny Brads. I think I've used them on every layout I've made with this collection. And I've used up all my butterflies. I need more of those butterflies. So I think I'm going to be putting an order very soon for this very same collection. And with the butterflies, some of them I've actually, to get, add a bit of dimension, I actually put some foam behind them. And I'm so pleased with this layout. It's very feminine, but I'm really, really happy with it. And another thing about this layout is that it has more dimension than what I normally put on my layouts, because I'm always conscious of the fact that my layouts are going to go in my albums, and so I try to make them as flat as possible. But this one, and especially that butterfly that I'm working on now, and it's got all the enamel dots, and there's enamel dots on my little, where my journal is, lots of dimension. So this one is going to make my album a little bit more bulky, but you know what, I love it, and that's all that matters. And I might even put it on my walls instead. Who knows? So we're nearly at the end here. I want to take this opportunity to thank you all for watching. I want to thank all my subscribers, and I love the comments. I love every single comment that I get, and I do reply to everybody. So thank you all so much. There are some still photos coming up. And till next time, please stay safe. And happy scrapping, everybody. I hope to catch you all soon. And please, if you haven't already done so, I would love to have you as a subscriber. So hit that subscription button and also the bell so you get notified of any future videos that I do. All right. Bye, everybody.